NBA star Omri Caspi of the Sacramento Kings is a very popular player. In fact, he has an entire country behind him, the state of Israel.
How you been, Omri? Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. What?
Nothing but comedians in here. They could do stand-up comedy.
We got a lot of funny guys. Yeah. How you doing, man? Good?
I'm good. Everybody's making fun of Jason's shirt. They said it's terrible.
Spencer White?
Hey.
Get a picture of that shirt. Get a look at that shirt.
Worst shirt in NBA history.
Where can I buy such a shirt?
I'm sure
it's JT.
It's limited edition.
He said limited edition.
One of the top rookies in the NBA.
Pretty good. Working hard, getting better, trying to focus and keep my leg fresh all the time to a lot of games. But feel good.
When you were 10 years old, you stood in front of the Garden and you said, one day I'll be in the NBA. Now it's running as a Nike commercial. First commercial, first player in Israel to have a Nike commercial.
You got a Nike commercial?
Who does? Not
yet.
Where
at?
Is that legit?
In Israel.
Oh, is it in Israel?
Is that YouTube?
Yeah, you saw it.
Well, man, nah, he's like, I'm gonna see it a lot of times when I'm out there. It was Kavi.
Get it in.
Tell me.
Your teammate told me they're excited. They want to visit Israel this summer.
I hope so.
Well, I already got my ticket.
Yeah?
Fearless Caspi and Nike commercial. Is that you?
You're gonna watch
it right now?
Oh shit. Every boy has a dream.
For real, that's what it's called.
Yeah.
What song is it?
That's
just Grandmaster.
Mom and Dad, I promise you, I get the NBA. That's what I'm gonna play.
What do you say about the commercial?
Let me see it.
It's good.
Playback,
it's good. It's a great commercial.
Are you surprised you didn't know? Look how humble your teammate is. He didn't even tell you.
Humble? Humble,
oh,
Omri?
Oh, shoot.
Humble. Woo.
Hey, that's Kobe over here, man.
They said your commercial is kind of hot.
It's pretty nice. Pretty proud of it. It's a very nice commercial. I like it.
So
it was my bar mitzvah trip.
Really? Your bar mitzvah trip was
to
New York, and you said one day you'll play in the NBA. Now you're doing it.
Yeah.
Chill.
It was my bar mitzvah trip. And as a young guy, you know, it was a dream.
And Omri, what's it like to be the best Jewish basketball player in the world for you?
It's fried strawberry, son.
I don't know if I'm the best, but I'm just happy to represent, you know, Jewish people in the States and my country. And it's just a great feeling.
The Michael Jordan of Israel.
He is.
I mean, you know, he just doesn't represent, you know, you know, he represents Israel, he represents, you know, Jewish community, he represents a lot of things, not just himself, his family, and stuff like that.
Who's the toughest guy you faced in the NBA so far?
Oh, man.
Is it Tyreek Evans in practice every day?
Every day, man. He's going hard, man. But, you know, when he's going down the lane, I'm blocking that all day. Nah. We got tough guys.
What's it like for you to experience this following all the people from Israel, all the Jewish community?
Oh, it's funny. It's good to see him out there. You know, every city we go to, you know, he definitely brings our fan base and gets the crowd into it, and everybody cheers when he scores, and they got his own little chant, so it's cool.
What do you think about Omri Caspi and what he's bringing to the team?
He's been fantastic. He, you know, you were there in Summer League in July in Vegas where he didn't, I mean, kind of, he looked like a good story, but a guy who might be in the D League. He wasn't playing too well, and it's been phenomenal. I mean, you know, obviously in that rookie sophomore game in Dallas, he's been a champion, I think, honestly, of the people. The way that he handles the media, the attention from his homeland, I have a ton of respect for it. I've seen it every single day. He's gracious. He's willing. He doesn't complain behind closed doors. He just really embraces it. So he's been fun to cover.
The whole game, I hear fans screaming your name. You hear them, or are you too focused?
I'm trying to focus, man. I'm trying.
You hear him. I hear him.
You hear him? You hear them calling
out? I hear him. He hear him.
What did they yell?
What you saying?
Speech.
In Hebrew? People in America don't know that Israeli media's vision is like TMZ times 100. They're cutthroat. They don't care if you're the prime minister or you're a bubble. They go after you. And he's handling it with great.
I know that, Ellie, since I get phone calls from the Israeli media. And every time it's, hey, what's going on? I think it's this has happened, all these conspiracy theories, you know. And if somebody told me, it's like the New York media on steroids. He deserves even more credit for the way that he's conducted himself. Because, you know, that's tough to deal with, but he's been pretty classy about it.
You're on the road with him day in, day out. Have you ever seen a player in Sacramento with such following? I mean, you weren't there with Weber.
No, not even close. I mean, it's not even in Sacramento. You really see it when he goes on the road in every city. The flags are waving. The fans are going nuts. People in Sacramento obviously love him, but it's nationwide and obviously it's global. But it's pretty, you know, it's pretty neat.
Can you tell me about the conversation you had with Kobe, where he told you he wants to learn Hebrew?
Oh man, he just asked me in the game that where I'm from, and I said I'm from Israel, and I asked him to speak Hebrew. He said he's not. He don't speak Hebrew. I know he speaks a lot of languages, so.
There you have it, Omri Kaspi and the Sacramento Kings. In Los Angeles, I'm Eli Sekbak, reporting.